Logan is the newest film in the X-Men universe. And it is the third Wolverine movie and supposedly Hugh Jackman's last stand as Wolverine slash Logan. And in this movie, it takes place in the future, which is also known as the revised timeline from X-Men Days of Future Past. All the mutants are gone, including the X-Men, and all we have left is Logan slash Wolverine and Professor X. And both of them are old, and they're just, at this point in their lives, they're at their lowest low. Logan, he's a limo driver, and he's had enough. And then Professor X, he's a bit of a reclusive. He has dementia, he's losing his mind, he's having seizures, and he's just lost all hope. Until one day, the two of them come across this little girl that is a little defensive than they think. But she needs their help, in which the three of them, they embark on this road trip. Which I'm not going to spoil for you, but as this road trip goes along for them, they find each other and they find themselves, and they have a sense of meaning in their lives again. Particularly Logan, this girl has more connection to Logan than the both of them think. Now, I absolutely love this film. This is the best of the X-Men films, and let alone the best Wolverine movie. Like, Hugh Jackman as Logan in this movie, oh my god, if he does not get an Academy Award next year for this movie, or at least a nomination, I'm gonna flip the freak out. Because he definitely shows that this is his last hurrah as Wolverine. And even Professor X, like, they take a turn with Professor X that I just wasn't expecting, but considering where he's at in his life right now, it definitely makes sense. And just watching both Logan and Professor X, watching the two of them banter back and forth, it was just hilarious, but at the same time, it made sense. The little girl who plays Laura, aka, okay, look, I ain't gonna lie, I'm just gonna go ahead and spoil it because, well, it's in the trailers and it's pretty much revealed who she is. But pretty much, the little girl is X-23. But the little girl that plays her, she was great. She was savage when she needed to be savage, and she was quiet and humble and just a bit of a mystery when she needed to be all those things. And watching her connect with Logan in the movie, it definitely makes sense. The thing that makes this movie so great is the layers behind it, because, you know, Logan, again, he's old and he's lost all hope and he doesn't know what to do with himself, and then he finds himself in this little girl that might give him a bit of hope and it gives him a sense of purpose again. And again, this is the most character driven of the X-Men films. And I also got to touch on the action in this movie. Now prior to me seeing this movie, I already knew this movie was going to be rated R, but it really didn't hit me that this movie was rated R once I saw the beginning of this movie. And just that first scene where a bunch of Mexicans are stealing the rims off Logan's limo tires, and just the action in that scene, just watching Logan slicing and dicing and cutting off arms, limbs, and heads. Like, I remember I just saw that and I was just like, shit, 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 shit. This is definitely not PG-13 Wolverine. And I love it. This was the Wolverine film we have been waiting for. Really, all the action set pieces in this movie are fantastic. This is definitely an R-rated Wolverine movie. But I really mean the action is great in the movie, because you also got to think, like, we're coming off of X-Men Apocalypse. Now, while I enjoyed X-Men Apocalypse, but let's be real, most of the action set pieces in that movie are just nothing but a bunch of fun CGI nonsense. As opposed to in this movie, this has a very dark, gritty feel to it, which again, I also love about this movie. This film pretty much feels like an independent film in which, you know, it's a post-apocalyptic, but it's not post-apocalyptic. It has a Western feel to it that just makes it feel authentic, real,
and a bit grounded in reality. And that credit goes to James Mangold, who you remember directed The Wolverine, and I'm so glad he came back for this movie, because he definitely took inspiration from some of his favorite Westerns and applied it to this movie, because this movie is like The Dark Knight. Where The Dark Knight, even though it was a comic book film, it didn't feel like it was. It felt more like a crime mystery drama, as opposed to this one. This is also a little bit more dramatic of the X-Men films. And again, that credit goes to James Mangold for the direction he brought to this film, because this is definitely not your typical comic book film. Really, if I had any negatives about this movie, it's just, I guess, a small one, just a personal one, but I just feel like the third act of the movie, I feel kind of dragged on a bit. But if it not wasn't for that final action set piece, it made the third act all the more worth it for me.
So again, I think it's just a personal thing where it's just I just don't like long ass movie because again, I just felt like the third act kind of dragged on a little bit to the point where it just felt like a 3-hour movie, and I thought the film was gonna pretty much start wrapping up at a certain point, but it did. It just kept going and going and going, but I loved every minute of it because again, the last action set piece made the rest of the third act as well as the rest of the film all the more worth it.
But in the end, I loved Logan. This is the Wolverine film that we've been waiting for. It's a very grounded, character-driven story about just a man, slash mutant, that's just, he's at his lowest low, and he's just lost all hope, and then he finds hope again. This little girl helps him with that, and that also goes to Professor X as well, and just, again, the direction they took with him, I did not expect that, but it made sense for what he was trying to do to help Logan. And not everything is all bad in the film because, you know, I just love the dinner table scene where all of them just sitting together eating. And, you know, it's just one of those things where, like, hey, men and Jill got to smile every once in a while, so all hope is not lost. But I love this film. It is one of my absolute favorites of the year. I'm definitely interested to see what they do with this franchise next. I'm going to give Logan 5 stars for it's a masterpiece. Guys, thank you so much for listening. If you want to see more, go ahead and check out my channel. The link is in the description below. And if you like this video, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. And be sure to check me out on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, MoviePilot, and Periscope. Peace.